What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about deploying the new Microsoft Team app with SCCM. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is download the new Microsoft Team app. So open up your favorite browser. We're going to go to this link. Once you're here, we're going to scroll down a little bit, and it gives you two options. The one that we're going to choose is on the right-hand side, so we're going to click on download the new Teams app. It's going to start downloading. Awesome. And there it goes. So for me, it downloaded inside the downloads folder. It is a MSIX file. So once the file is downloaded, we need to move it. Well, I moved it. And the reason why I moved it is because I have a shared, and this is where I dropped it inside sources, apps, Microsoft Teams. And I dropped that MSIX file in there. I'm actually going to copy that path because we are going to be needing that network path pretty soon. So we relocated our application. It is time for us to create our package. So open up your configuration manager. From here, we're going to go into the software tab. We're going to go inside the application management. We're going to click on packages. Now, you're able to do packages. You're able to do an application. You're able to do it by script. There's so many ways to do it. I'm going to do it as a package. So I'm going to right-click the packages, click on Create Package. You're going to get the wizard. I'm going to give it a name and a description, a manufacturer, and a language. This is what I provided. I'm going to check off this package contains source files. I'm going to click on Browse, and I'm going to paste that network path. Let's click OK. Let's click Next here. This is going to be a standard program, so click Next. And provide a name. This is what I gave it. And for the command line, I'm actually entering this. I'm going to run a PowerShell script. So you probably say to yourself, what's this PowerShell script? You didn't show us. I'm going to show you. So this install teams.ps1 file is actually located where I dropped the MSIX file. So we're going to open it up, and it's this. It's actually using the add provision appx package command with a parameter of online, with another parameter of package path, and providing the UNC path of the MSIX file. And then we're going to use the skip license parameter. I'm going to highlight this command, right-click on it, and then copy, and then paste it within the command line text box. Within this dialog box, I'm going to actually click on the drop-down menu for program can run, and I'm going to change it to whether or not the user is logged in. And then we're going to click on Next. I left everything as the default for the requirements, so click Next here. A nice little summary, click Next, and green check mark, which is always a good thing. So let's click on Close. Now, once your package is done, we need to distribute the content. So right-click on your new package, and we're going to pick Distribute Content. Click Next here. Let's click on Add. Pick Distribution Point. Select your DP. Click OK. Click Next here, a nice little summary, click Next, and you're done. So let's close it. Before I do anything else, on the lower right-hand side on the content status, it's going to change to in progress. I like to wait until it changes to success for me to go, green go, right? So once you've done all that, it is time to deploy a package. So right-click on it, click on Deploy, click on Browse, and select your collection. Now, my collection that I'm going to deploy this is install new Microsoft Teams. Pretty self-explanatory. Click OK. Click Next here. I don't have to do anything here, so click Next. Definitely required, so click Next here. Click on New. We're going to pick Assign immediately after event, as soon as possible. Click OK. Click Next here. For the user experience, the only thing that I'm going to do here is just check off software installation and then click on Next. For the distribution point, I'm going to pick on the second option dropdown, and I'm going to change it to download the content from the DP and run it locally. Click Next. A nice little summary. Click Next. Green check mark. Again, always a good thing to see a green check mark, and then close it. All right, so I'm going to show you guys the collection because the collection only has one computer and we're going to validate it. So this is the collection. I only have this computer, and it's called BTNHD01. And we're going to head to this machine. This is the machine. If you don't trust me, I open up command prompt, and I just type in host name, right? BTNHD01. That's the one that's inside the collection. And I also did a who am I, because I'm running it as an administrator. I want to make sure that the package is pushed out system-wide, meaning if another user logs into this machine, they should get that Microsoft Teams app within their profile. And I'm going to show you guys later on. So I open up Control Panel. Within Control Panel, I clicked on Configuration Manager. I went to Actions. I selected the first option and I clicked on Run Now. You're going to get this informative dialog box. And the reason why I did this is because I want to speed up the process. So click OK. You can also go inside the C drive, Windows, CCM cache, and you should see a new folder. For me, it was number 2. When I went inside number 2, I should see my PowerShell script as well as the MSIX file. Awesome. If you give it some time, eventually you should see it within the start menu. Now, like I said before, I wanted to test whether or not if I log into another account, which I did. I logged into the same machine, different account, Beer Roadshow, and I went to start, and the application was there, which is great. That's the way that we want this package to be deployed system-wide. Now, if you select it and you run it, you're going to get this. The next video, hopefully you guys check it out. I show you guys how to get this working with SCCM. Don't get me wrong, you're able to download the Edge Web View 2 extension and install it, but you want to deploy it to the massive. So I want to show you guys how to do that on the next video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.